That may look confusing on the surface, but if you saw the last bits of binary episode, it might make some sense. I'll explain it in more detail in this episode of the House of Hacks. Hi, makers, builders, and do-it-yourselfers, Harley here. This is a continuation in the series on bits of binary. In previous episodes, I explored the concept of binary numbers, how to count in binary, how to convert between binary and decimal, and in the last episode, I showed how to add binary numbers together. In this episode, I'll show the simple, obvious way to subtract them that's analogous to how we first learned them in decimal. In a future episode, I plan to introduce the non-intuitive way negative numbers are stored in computers and how that impacts subtracting binary numbers. Remember last time when we talked about addition? We looked at these two tables. Let's remember how we use this with decimal numbers. We'll ignore negative numbers for now, so we'll establish the rule that the first number has to be larger than the second. Since this half of the table is the same as this half, we'll just ignore one side. When describing the process, we'll use the example 8 minus 5. The process is to first find the entries in the table for the first number. Then, of those entries, you find the one with the other number in the header. The answer is the other header value. Well, binary is exactly the same way, just with a much smaller table, or written as a series of equations that looks like this. The first three probably make intuitive sense, as they are the same as decimal, but the last one may not be quite so obvious. Remember that in binary, the value for 2 is represented by 10. If we recall from grade school with multi-column numbers, when we subtract a larger number from a smaller one, we have to borrow from the next higher column. Let's take, for example, 21 minus 13 in decimal. The units column is 1 minus 3. Well, we can't do that, so we borrow 1 from the 2 in the second column, giving us 11 minus 3. This gives us 8. Moving to the next column, we now have 1 minus 1, giving us 0. Binary works exactly the same way. Let's look at some examples in binary. First, something simple, 6 minus 2. The units column is 0 minus 0, which equals 0. The next column is 1 minus 1, which equals 0 again. The final column is 1 minus 0, giving us 1. This gives us an overall result of 100, or the value of 4. Now let's do something with some borrowing. 6 minus 3. The units column is 0 minus 1. We can't do that, so we're going to borrow a 1 from the next column. Now we have 10 minus 1, giving a result of 1. Because of the previous borrow, the second column is 0 minus 1. So again, we borrow from the next higher column, giving us 10 minus 1 with a result of 1. The final column is 0 because of the previous borrow, minus 0, giving us 0. Overall, the result is 1, 1, or a value of 3. And that's it. Subtraction is a bit more complicated due to the borrowing, but again, it's just a known concept applied in a slightly different way. Thanks for watching this episode of Bits of Binary. As I mentioned earlier, a future episode will explain how negative numbers are handled in a computer in a less intuitive, but ultimately easier way to handle subtraction. But in the next episode, I'll look at multiplying binary numbers together. I've created a playlist over here that has all the past episodes and will be filled in as more episodes in this series are added. If you like this, let me know with a thumbs up. If you have any thoughts or questions on this topic, I'd love to hear them in the comments below. If you're already a subscriber, thank you. And if you haven't done so already, be sure to subscribe so you don't miss future topics such as this one, high-speed photography, making a digital computer with 19th century technology, and much more. Until next time, go make something. It doesn't have to be perfect, just have fun.